Welcome to our Ms. Excel report tutorial. Today we will learn to use the drop-down effectively and create report using a drop-down list box. We will learn to summarize data using asterisks and partial phrases in the list box. We hope you enjoy our tutorial and apply the ideas in your own reports and dashboards. So let's start our tutorial now. We have a quarterly sales dataset, which we will use to create a simple dashboard in MS Excel. We have data of 2023 and 2024 in our Excel file. The data contains quarterly numbers of sales, with further detail of cash and credit sales. Then we have the cost and profit, along with number of employees and bad debts of each store. We have the data of each store, which are identified by their location, including country, region, city, and locality. To use a drop-down list, we will first create a column here, named Lookup. In this column, we will use the concatenate function to combine country, region, city, and locality. We will use comma symbol to separate each location level. When they are combined, we have full address of a store in one cell. We will now apply this function to the entire dataset by dragging the function all the way to the last row. Now we can use this column to look up a store using a drop-down list box. Now, we will create a new sheet and rename it to Lookup. Then we will copy the content of Lookup column and paste here in the column A without any heading. After pasting the list here, we will remove all the duplicate values using the Remove Duplicate button. This list will be used in the drop-down list box to select a store, region, or country and display its data. Now we can create a new sheet for our report. And here, we will select a cell for our drop-down list to select country, region, or store. We can go to the Data Validation button and select List from the Allow field. And in the source field, we can give the entire column from lookup sheet, where list of stores is placed. This way, any value added to the list will automatically be available in the drop-down list. The drop-down list is not sorted, which makes it difficult to look for a store and select it. We can sort this list, and the list in drop-down list box will automatically be sorted in the same way. Now our drop-down list is properly sorted, and items are easy to locate and select. Before moving ahead with our report, let's create a new sheet and rename it to Summary. On this sheet, we will create all columns which contain dates and numbers. We can copy column headings from the data sheet. Then we will copy the entire quarter-ended column which contains all dates. We will select the entire column from data sheet and paste it in the summary sheet. Then we will remove duplicates for this column and select the appropriate format for dates. We will also make sure that the dates are sorted in the descending order, making the latest date appear on top of the list. Using the SUMIFS function, we will get the values of each item. We will select the relevant column in the sum range. We should not freeze this column using dollar sign though. We can unfreeze it later. Then we will select the date field from the data sheet to sum the range by date. Then we will select the date from summary sheet as criteria for date column. We will select the lookup column for data range as another criteria range, and then select the drop-down list cell from the report sheet as criteria. So, when a location is selected in the drop-down list box, the values for that location appear in the summary sheet. Currently, no location is selected, therefore the value is zero. Let's select a location here. As you can see, there is now a value in the cell. Let's apply this formula to the entire summary. The values are wrong, because we froze the sum range column. Let's unfreeze the column and drag the formula again to apply it correctly to the entire summary. Now all values should appear accurately based on relevant date and location selected in drop-down list. Back to the report sheet, let's make every column 20 pixel wide. We will create three headings to display sales information, including cash sales, credit sales, and total sales. Then we will want to include bad debts and employees as well, and analyze bad debts per employee as well. We also want to know the sales, costs, and the profit or loss earned during the quarter. And we also would like to analyze this information per employee basis. To do that, we will divide each number by total employees. We will display the data of latest quarter in this report, therefore we will simply select each value from the top row of the summary sheet. To get the per employee analysis, we will simply divide each value by the number of total employees. Then we will format all numbers using the comma sign button in the number section. We will add borders around each section to make the report look visually appealing. And we will also make the text in drop-down bigger. Let's remove the extra spaces by reducing the width and height of columns and rows in between. Make all the headings bold to make them look better. Also, we can add some style to the numbers as well. Let's make the location bold as well. And remove the grid lines too. Now, before moving ahead, make sure that the report is working properly by selecting values from the drop-down list and changing locations. You may have noticed that we have several stores in many countries. Like we have three stores in United States. You can get the total values of entire country as well. Write the country name inside asterisks to display the data of entire country, like so. The drop-down is designed to summarize data this way, without any further effort. For individual stores, you can just select a value from drop-down list. We can further add historical analysis, using bar charts or line charts. Simply select the quarters, cash sales, credit sales, and total sales columns from the summary sheet and insert a line chart. Then change the chart type to combo chart and MPVE the total sales line to secondary y-axis. Keep cash sales and credit sales on the primary axis as columns. Change the chart title to sales. Move the chart to the report page and add borders around the chart as well. Now, as you can see, as we select a location from the drop-down list, the report is updated accordingly, including the combo chart. Similarly, we will create another chart by selecting quarter ended, sales, cost, and profit columns. And just like before, we will change this chart into a combo chart and move the profit line to a secondary y-axis. We will change the title of this chart to profitability. And move this chart to the report sheet next to the sales chart. We will add a border to this chart as well, and place it properly next to the sales chart. Our report with drop-down list is now complete. You can select any location from the drop-down, and data in the report will automatically be updated. You can use asterisks to summarize the report by country as well. You can even use a partial phrase to summarize data. Thanks for watching. We hope you liked our tutorial. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for more insightful tutorials and updates.